In this video, we're going to look at a feature in Safari on the iPhone that lets you translate a website or translate selected text within a website to a different language. This can be useful if you encounter content on a web page that is in an unfamiliar language. With Safari's Translate feature, you're able to translate that website or selected text within just a few taps. Let's see how. Now, before we dive in, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can translate websites with Safari on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. First thing I want to mention is I am using an iPhone 15 with iOS 18. But don't let that stop you. If you're using an older version of iOS, this should still work. This is not an iOS 18 feature. The way that you access it might change slightly because Apple moves things around a little bit, but I think if you follow along, even with older versions of iOS, you should be able to use this feature. All right, so I'm looking at Wikipedia here. This is in Safari. And what I would like to do is I would like to translate this. Being that I'm looking at Canadian Football League, maybe I want to look at this in French. Well, in order to do that, the first thing that we need to do is we need to add French as a second language to the iPhone. Until we do that, we will not be able to translate anything in Safari. So the first thing we need to do is we need to add our languages that we don't translate to, and we can add more than one. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to the Settings app. So I'm going to swipe up, and then we're going to go over here to Settings. Under Settings, what we need to do is go over to General, and then under General, what you're going to see is, when I swipe up here, Language and Region. This is where we go and add the languages. Once I add the languages, then I'll be able to go back into Safari and translate a web page. So let's tap on that, and we're going to add a couple of languages in here. We're going to go and add French as well as Spanish. So now what I do is I just tap on Add Language. And then I go and select the language I want to add. We have to do this one at a time. So I'm going to go with Spanish here. Tap on it. And then what we need to do is we need to tell the iPhone what we want to use as our primary language. Well, English is my primary language, so I'm going to tap on English. All I want to do is I want to be able to translate into a second language, so we're not changing our primary language. So I'm going to tap on Use English as our primary language. So it's updating the languages. Takes a few seconds. And now you're going to see that I have Spanish in here. Let's go and add another one. Like I said, we can't add more than one. We're going to add French in here. So now I just go and tap on Add Language again. And then we swipe up until we find French. So now I tap on that. I have to select Use English as my primary language again. And then it's going to load that language. So now I have my languages here. English in my primary language, and then I also have Spanish and French. Now we're able to translate text. So how do we do that? Well, we have to go back into Safari. We set it up. Now we can use that feature. So I'm going to open up Safari here again. And being that I have those loaded, when I tap on this little page view icon or page menu icon, this gives me a number of different tools where I can go and resize the text. I can turn it or turn on reader view. I can go and add it to my reading list. But we have a new option here now that we've added some languages. You're going to see that I have Translate Website. You will not see this until you add those languages. So now I tap on Translate Website. And being that I have two different languages, I have to decide which one I want to use. So we're going to go with French here. So now I just tap on French. And it's going to translate this website into French. And now we can see it is in French. We can see that it is translating it not only because the text is in French, but also the icon view changes here. To change it back, all we have to do is just tap on that, and then we go over to View Original. When I view Original, it's going to bring it back over to my primary language, English in my case here. So that's how we can easily translate an entire website. What about selected text? We can also translate selected text. Well, the first thing we need to do is we need to select text. So I'm just going to select some text here. And let's just go with this here. I want to translate this here. How do we do that? Well, when we select text, you're going to see that there's a little pop-up menu here. And in this pop-up menu, we have a number of different tools. One of them is going to be Translate. Well, you don't see it here because it just says Copy and Writing Tools. I do have Apple Intelligence on here. We're not talking about Apple Intelligence, but that's what Writing Tools is. So what I need to do is I need to go over here to the little arrow. I tap on the right arrow. We have more options. And then you're going to see Translate. So now all I need to do is just tap on that. And what it'll do is it'll translate that selected text. And in this case here, what it did is it translated into Spanish. Well, I want it in French. Well, all you need to do is just tap on that. And then from here, you can select French. And now we can see it is in French. And it's only translating the text that I have selected, not the entire web page. So that is how we translate text with Safari on the iPhone. The key to making this work is adding those other languages to the iPhone. And you do this through the Settings app. You go to Settings, General, and then you're going to see Language and Region. And from there, what you're able to do is add the other languages that you'd like to translate to. Once you add those, what you're going to be able to do when you go back into Safari is go and translate the entire website. Or you can select the text, and with the pop-up menu, you can translate that selected text to another language. So that's how we translate text with Safari on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can subscribe to my channel. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. With danstutorials.com, not only do I have more videos, but I also have an AI assistant that is modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, the website is a membership-based site. When you do become a member, I remove all of the ads from the videos. I don't remove the videos, just the ads from the videos. You also have access to that AI assistant that I mentioned, and you have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. I'm not part of some large organization or anything. I just have a second bedroom that I turned into an office or into a studio where I record these videos. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.